Everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting. This is cost, volume, profit. These are some examples of how we determine break even. So before we go any further, I want to remind you of the other video that I've made on this because we're going to be going ahead and using some of those ratios. So let's go ahead and look at our two examples. So our first example is YYZ sells inventory for $500 per unit and it has variable costs of $85 per unit. Assuming that fixed costs are $622,500, how many units need to be sold to achieve break-even? Prepare a variable costing income statement. Our second example is YYZ sells inventory for $600 per unit. It has a contribution margin of $335 per unit. Assuming fixed costs are $536, how many new units need to be sold to achieve break-even? What were YYZ's total variable costs? And prepare a variable costing income statement. So those are going to be the two examples we're going to look at today. And let's go ahead, before I say thank you and goodbye, let's actually go do the work. So here are the ratios that we will more than likely be using or that we will need for this question. And let's go ahead first. I want to first go through and actually use the ratios to solve it. Then we'll go through and prove it through. So how many units need to be sold to achieve break even? So for that one, we're going to need our fixed costs are $622,500. And I'm also going to need what is my contribution margin per unit. Now, my contribution margin per unit is going to be my sales price per unit of $500 less my variable cost per unit of $85. So my contribution margin per unit is going to be 415. Okay, so right over here, my contribution margin per unit is going to be 415. So what this tells me is that my units to be sold to achieve break even are going to be 1500. Now, even if the question didn't ask you for this, this is going to be something you're going to want to do with every single one of these questions. Trust me. Okay. You want to make sure you do this because we have to make sure that it's right. If I look at what we know, right, and what we do know is this, we know that our sales, variable costs, my contribution margin, my fixed costs, and then my net income. My net income, if I'm doing a break-even analysis, my net income is gonna have to be zero. What I also know over here though, that my fixed costs are gonna be $622,500. I also know that in terms of a per unit basis, because remember, going back to over here, this is why this matrix is so important. Our sales are gonna be our units times the sales price per unit, variable costs. If I sold this many units, I need this many units in terms of going to variable costs. My contribution margin is going to be the same number of units. So over here, I know that my per unit sales price is 500. I know that my variable costs per unit are 85, and that's how we came up with our contribution margin of $415 per unit. Now, over here, what I'm saying is, well, to achieve break even, I need 1500 units. Let's see if this works. So over here, if I take 1500 times 415, I get 622,500. Wow, how that works out. So again, this is how we're kind of going through and kind of doing a little math here to kind of go through and to figure out how much do we have to make in terms of a contribution margin to cover our fixed costs. Now let's do the rest of this contribution margin or this variable costing income statement. So if I had 1500 units that I have a contribution margin for, that means I must have had 1500 units of variable costs. And so now when I multiply this through, 1500 times 500 is 750,000. 1500 times 85 is 127,500. And when I subtract 127.5 from 750, I get to 622.500. Again, the reason why I'm taking the time to show you this is an example that I made up. But the reason why I'm taking the time to show you this is where I see students make mistakes. They will go through and will solely rely on this part right over here. And as you can see, just to plug in the amounts doesn't really take me that long of a time to go through and do. Let's take a look at our second example right over here. So YYZ, got to get rid of that answer, right? You can't have the Chegg here. I'm going to give you the Chegg in just a moment, right? My Chegg is a little bit different though, because my Chegg is free on YouTube with minimal advertisements. Okay. Yeah, I don't get me started on that company. It's more, I'm more upset with the publishers, but what are you going to do? Okay, so YYZ sells its inventory for $600 per unit, and it has a contribution margin per unit of $335. If fixed costs are $536, how many units to sell do we need? How many units do we need to sell to achieve break even? What are the variable costs? Wow, look at that. Good job, Tchaikovsky. This is why I never grade my students on spelling. Prepare a variable costing income statement. So what are we going to do? Well, we can do this in a couple of different ways, right? But let's go ahead and how do we want to go through and do it? Let's try a different way. Let's go first and try to see if we can figure out the dollar sales that we need to achieve break even. That might work. Let's check it out. My fixed costs are $536,000. Okay. My contribution margin ratio. Now, again, this is going to be a little bit different than what we saw up there. This is basically going to be my sales or 600, but look at this. I'm not given my variable cost, but I'm giving the contribution margin of 335. If I take 335 and divide it by 600, okay, I'm going to come up over here with 0.558333. So let's go ahead and see if we can get this to work. So if I take this over here, I'm going to come up with 960,000 in total sales. So this is my contribution margin ratio. Before I go any further, I want to make sure that we all understand this. When I'm looking over here at my contribution margin ratio, I don't know what my sales are and I don't know what my variable costs are, but I do know what my contribution margin per unit is. And let me show you why. If my sales price per unit is 600 and my contribution margin per unit is 335, that means my variable cost per unit should be 265 because of this relationship. Meaning that my sales price per unit minus my variable cost per unit gives me my contribution margin per unit. That's where this is coming from. So could I have done instead of this, could I have done 600 minus 265? The answer is yes, it's going to give me that 335. So let's go ahead and how many units do we have to sell? I don't know, but let's go ahead and plug this into our matrix. What is our matrix, right? It's the first one, which was the best of the whole series. So I have my sales, my variable costs. This is going to give me my contribution margin. I've got my fixed costs, and this is going to give me my net income, right? I know that my net income has to be zero. Why? We're talking about break even. So this has to be zero. I know that my fixed costs are 536,000. And let's put in the other information that we know. Units per unit, and we've got our total. So over here, my per unit for sales was 600. My contribution margin per unit was 335, right? So over here, we've said that our total sales were 960,000. Okay, so how many units did I need to sell? Well, I don't know the number of units, but I know whatever the number of units are times 600 is going to give me 960,000. So over here, I take 960 divided by 600 and I get 1,600 units. Remember, 1600 times 600 is going to give me 960,000. If I sold 1600 units, that must mean I must have taken 1600 units to variable costs, and my contribution margin is also going to be for 1600 units. My variable costs are going to be 265. Why 265? Because 600 minus 265 gives me my contribution margin per unit. If I multiply 1600 times 265, I get 424. When I subtract 424 from 960, I get 536. When I take 1600 and multiply it by 335, I get 536. Another thing I could have done to solve this question as well is I could have taken my fixed costs and I could have divided it by my contribution margin per unit. My contribution margin per unit is going to be 335. So my units sold to achieve break even is going to be 1600. Okay. Now, what you'll notice here is I can solve this problem multiple ways. The most important piece of advice, though, that I can give you heading into some of these later questions is to make absolutely sure that you take the results of what you come up with from the ratios and you plug it in to make sure that it works. If you don't do that on exams, it may not turn out the way you want it to. But in any event, I want to thank you for joining me here today. Those are my two examples for, as of right now, I'm going to have more for you. I want to thank you for joining me here today. Please leave any kind of questions you have below. And I appreciate you liking and subscribing to the videos. Have a great day.